The other night, I did a little video about the Rambam's 7 rules of how a husband is supposed to treat a wife. Some of you, I'm sure, saw that little video. And here's the Rambam's 7 rules. He says a husband is obligated to respect his wife more than himself. That's number one. Number two, he's obligated to love his wife like himself. Number three is if he has a lot of money, he has to give her according to the money he has. So if he has a medium salary, he has to give her a medium amount. If he has more, he has to give more. And part of it, I said, as long as Hashem, if I could afford the extra $1,000 a month, then I have to do it. That's my responsibility. Again, right after he says number three, which is you have to provide as much as you can. Number four is don't create fear in the home. Some men do this. They make it scary to be in the house when they're angry or flipping out or when someone spent too much money. Number five is you should speak to her softly. Not just when you're walking at sunset in Turks and Caicos. You should speak to her softly even on the night that she didn't make dinner right and on the night that she's frustrated in bed because her day didn't go well. Number six is do not be depressed. And number seven is do not be angry. You heard these 7 rules? There's not a man on earth that could keep all 7. But you heard these 7 rules? They're very difficult, but there's something to strive for. So what I heard happen from a lot of people is that there were a lot of women who then took this little video of mine and sent it to their husband. Said, honey, listen to what Rabbi Haber had to say. So my message to all those women is that the Rambam has another paragraph. Are you ready for the next paragraph? Here we go. Before you get excited for your husband to listen to this class, tell me if you're ready for him to listen to this. Our rabbis commanded to a woman that she should respect her husband more than enough, that she should be in awe of him, and she should do what he asks her to do. She should view him like a governor or a king. He kind of goes and comes at will, and anything that he hates, she removes from the home. You got it? Forget all the details. Here's what you're supposed to get. But the Rambam is saying is that our work we need to do is to treat each other with so much more respect than American society expects of us. We have such higher standards of how to talk to a wife and how to treat a husband. Our standards are basically a king and a queen. Our standards are respect and love and a higher regard than you even have for yourself. Our standards are no fear, no anger, just love and respect and care. That's the Torah's expectations.